The scenario series of videos addresses setup configurations for specific use cases. In this video, we have a scenario in which a car dealer, using networked loudspeakers on their property, wishes to play a recorded message to visitors on the lot after business hours, as well as notify certain staff members. This is a multi-step process, and we're going to guide you through each step along the way. To begin with, the customer will need to record their intended message.
Our office is currently closed. Please return when we open at 9:30 a.m.
The device we're using will support common formats such as WAV and MP3 files. Playing a recorded audio file is quite different from the two-way audio feature provided by ExactVision. Not all devices that support audio provide methods ExactVision can use to trigger the playback of an audio file. But in this instance, we are using an Axis C1310 network horn speaker with firmware 11.4.63. We'll log into the device, open the audio menu, and select Audio Clips. Select the Add Clip button, provide an identifying name, then select and upload the clip to be stored on the device. Next, follow the steps in the support article titled Using Axis Network Speakers with ExactVision to create a rule based on a digital output. Open the System menu and select Events. Here, we'll add a new rule and enter an easy-to-identify name, such as Dealer Lot Alert. From the Condition dropdown, select Digital Output is Active, and checkmark Use this condition as a trigger. The port will be set to Output 1. Select Play Audio Clip as the action. Then select the uploaded audio clip and press Save. If the speaker was previously added to ExactVision, you will need to disable and re-enable it. Otherwise, proceed with adding the network speaker to the ExactVision server. If you have more than one speaker, you will need to repeat each of the previous steps for each device. We must now determine how we want to trigger the audio file to play. Motion detection is widely available, even on inexpensive cameras, but may trigger more false positive events, annoying users. For our scenario, we're going to configure three different cameras that provide camera-based AI object classification of people. And we'll even go a bit beyond that to set rules for when people are lingering, since we only care to play the audio and send a notification when people are milling about on our dealer's property. We'll start with an Illustra Pro Gen 4 camera with firmware 24.03. After logging in, open the setup view. Expand the Event and Actions menu. Then select Analytics, followed by the AI Object Classification tab. AI Object Classification is enabled by default, but we want to create a rule to use within ExactVision's event linking, as well as configure a linger time. Press the New Rule button and enter a descriptive rule name. Leave the action field empty. Select Linger as the rule type, and Person as the object class. See Illustra documentation for details on other rule types and the overlap or confidence settings. We're going to set the linger time to 5 seconds. This is too low for most real-world uses, but okay for the purposes of demonstration and testing. Linger starts a timer when the detected object enters the area, but does not fire the event until they have been in the area for at least that amount of time. This permits people to walk through without triggering the event, but activates if they spend a longer time in the area than we define. You may need to adjust the time based on your installation environment. Finally, use the drawing tools to define the area of interest, in this case, our car dealer's lot. Click Save when done. Next, we'll set up an Axis P1455 LE with firmware 11.10.61. After logging into the camera, we head to the Apps page and enable Axis Object Analytics. Press the Open button. We will create a new scenario, as Axis calls them, from scratch. Select New Scenario, then select the type of scenario. In this case, we will select Time and Area, because we want to trigger our event after the person has lingered in the area for a given length of time. If the time did not matter, the object and area would be the better choice. Next, we can choose between detecting humans, vehicles, or both. We'll select human and click Next. Use the Edit option above to enter a descriptive name. Now use the handles of the region of interest to define the boundaries where the camera will look for people. We'll set the time and area to match the previous camera at 5 seconds. Again, too low for most situations, but decent for demonstrations and tests. Lastly, we'll configure a Hanwha PND A9081RV with firmware 2.21.13. Log in and enter the configuration page. Open the Analytics menu and select Wise AI. This particular camera doesn't provide the same options to create multiple rules, but provides settings to configure various uses. We'll select Object Detection, then select the object type we want to look for. In this case, person. Then change the minimum duration time, which acts as our linger time counter. It just so happens this camera only allows a maximum of 5 seconds. Next, select Exclude Area to mask off areas outside our property from detecting people. Remember to refer to the documentation from your camera provider for greater details on the settings for analytics. Whether using motion detection or analytics, there is no one-size-fits-all setting. Each must be adapted based on the individual scene activity and environmental conditions. With the cameras now configured, you'll add them to your Exacq Vision server. If they were previously added, disable and re-enable them. We now need to link the event trigger, person detection from the cameras, with the action we want, playing the audio clip. For this, we'll head over to the event linking page. We have a couple of options in configuring our event linking. We could opt for a one-to-one linking where we create one event link for each camera to each audio playback device. Here, we press the New button and select Analytics from the Event Type panel. If you are using motion detection instead of an analytic, select Video Motion. From the Event Source panel, we find each of our cameras and the configured analytics for person detection. The Action Type panel doesn't provide an audio playback option, but the steps we took earlier in configuring the speaker provide us with an output trigger. Select Output Trigger, then the speaker's output as the action target. We'll set up 3 event links, one for each camera. This one-to-one method is best for cases with only one or two cameras or sensors, but with multiple cameras as possible triggers, it will be more efficient to create a source group. We'll show this from the beginning of the event linking process. We press New to create a new event link, then select Source Group from the list of event types. In the window that appears, we'll begin by naming our new source group as Dealer Lot Person Detection. Under Group Event Sources, select the New button. Select Analytics from the Event Type panel. Under Event Source, we select the first of our camera analytics for person detection, making sure that When Alarmed is selected above. Repeat this step for each of our analytics. Before selecting Apply, change the Require setting to Any Source. Using the When Alarmed and Any Source settings will now trigger our source group when any of the 3 analytics are activated. After pressing Apply, our new source group appears in the Event Source list. We select Output Trigger from the Action Type panel, and the speaker from the Action Target before pressing Apply. We now have 1 item in our list of event linkages in place of 3 using the previously shown method. You may only select 1 action target for each source group, so if you have multiple speakers, you'll repeat the event linking for each device. This is a good point to test our setup so far. Lingering in front of our cameras should now trigger the playback of the audio clip loaded onto our network speakers.
Our office is currently closed. Please return when we open at 9:30 a.m.
The second part of our scenario requires sending a notification to a staff member of the car dealership. Using the Notifications page, Email Servers tab, we must first add an SMTP server to the system. Next, using the Email Message Profiles tab, we create an email profile, which includes the to and from addresses, as well as the message to be sent. Refer to the user manual or user training videos on notification configuration for more information. With the notification configured, we head back to the event linking page. Press the New button. We can now save time and keep our event linking list as tidy as possible by reusing our previously created source group from the event type and source panels. This time, our action type will be Notify, with the action target being the name of the email message profile we just created. A final test confirms that our audio message is played from the speakers and our notification message was successfully sent to the employees or owner of the facility. But that's not where this scenario ends. Part of the request is that this audio message and email notification only occur outside of business hours. We'll show two methods of accomplishing this. Firstly, we can use the schedule page. Locating our source group, we could highlight our normal business hours and change the setting from alarm to none. Don't forget to set this for each day of the week, and weekends will likely have different hours than weekdays. This is by far the easiest method. The only limitation of using the schedule page is that we are limited to full hours for each day. What if our start time is 9:30 a.m.? That's where things get a little trickier. Returning to the event linking page, one of our event type options is the time trigger, which allows us to enter specific time ranges. However, for this scenario, we can't mix these with our existing source group because we used any source as a requirement of our source group, and a time trigger will fire when that starting time is reached, regardless of the camera object detection. We are also not able to nest multiple source groups within each other. So if the simple solution using the schedule page does not suit your installation, we're going to show you how to work around this. We begin by deleting the prior event links created. Create a new event link and make a new source group. This time, we'll add just one of our cameras doing the detection. Then we add a time trigger named 9:30 a.m. to 7:30 p.m. weekdays, with a start time of 9:30 a.m., an end time of 7:30 p.m., and select weekdays as our frequency. The event source will be when not alarmed, since we want to send alerts outside of this time range. Finally, the requires field will be all sources. This is a departure from the previous setup of source groups because we ask that both of the sources listed be alarmed to trigger our source group action. Press apply and set the action target to the output trigger. Repeat these steps for the same camera, but with the weekend hours. Once that is done, you will have to repeat the previous steps for each camera, and repeat those steps again for each speaker. So while our event linking server actions list grows considerably, we are able to accommodate a finer level of control. The final activity would be performing these steps again for sending the notification. As we see, using source groups and full hours of scheduling is much simpler, but there are options for those with more challenging deployments. This video has walked you through the start to finish steps of configuring object detection analytics on different cameras, configuring source groups, notifications, and triggering playback of recorded audio clips from devices providing these features and supported by Exacq Vision. Continue to look for other videos from our scenario series on solutions to real-world customer needs.